This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Jonathan Anthony Wisniewski, born September 20, 1951, is an American professional wrestler, better known as Greg the Hammer Valentine. He is the son of wrestler Johnny Valentine. In the course of his career, which has spanned over 4 decades, Valentine has held more than 40 championships, including the NWA United States Heavyweight Championship and the WWF Intercontinental Heavyweight Championship, and alumnus of the World Wrestling Federation and World Championship Wrestling. He was inducted into the WWE Hall of Fame in 2004, and was also inducted into the Professional Wrestling Hall of Fame in 2016. Contents: 1. Professional Wrestling Career. 11. Training. 12. Early Years. 1970-1976-13 National Wrestling Alliance. 1976-1978-14 Worldwide Wrestling Federation. World Wrestling Federation. 1978-1979. 1981-1982-15 Return to the NWA. 1979-1984-16 Return to the WWF. 1984-1992-17 Return to WCW. 1992-18 Second return to the WWF. 1993-1994-19 Second return to the WCW. 1996-1998-110 Independent circuit. 1994-present. 111 Brief returns to WWE. 2004-2005-2008 2 Personal life. 3 Opinions towards female athletes. 4 In wrestling. 5 Championships and accomplishments. 6 References. 7 External links. Professional wrestling career training. Born in Seattle, Washington, Wisniewski traveled around Texas in his teens with his father during a summer vacation. He decided to drop out of college and become a wrestler. His father initially tried to deter him, but eventually ceded to his wishes and sent him to Canada in 1970 to train under Stu Hart in Calgary. Wisniewski remained in Canada for a year, wrestling his debut match in July 1970 against Angelo King Kong Mosca. He lost in around 5 minutes. 6 months later, Wisniewski relocated to Detroit to complete his training under the Sheik. Early years. 1970-1976 Initially reluctant to take his father's ring name, Wisniewski wrestled as Babyface Nelson before becoming Johnny Fargo, one half of the Fargo brothers, with Don Fargo. Between 1971 and 1974, the Fargo brothers initially competed in the Buffalo and Cleveland-based National Wrestling Federation before moving on to Texas. They split in 1974 and Wisniewski went to Florida, where he began performing as Johnny Valentine Jr., hopeful that he could live up to his father's legacy. He later changed his ring name to Greg the Hammer Valentine, and was billed as Johnny Valentine's brother, not his son, because of fears that the elder Valentine would be thought of as too old to be a legitimate threat. Valentine remained in Florida for a year while also working in Los Angeles and in Japan under Antonio Inoki in 1975 and early 1976. National Wrestling Alliance. 1976-1978 In August 1976, Valentine debuted in Jim Crockett Jr. and George Scott's Mid-Atlantic Championship Wrestling, an affiliate of the National Wrestling Alliance based in the Carolinas and Virginia's. Valentine was hired to replace his father, who had been forced to retire after he broke his back in a plane crash in 1975. He immediately began feuding with Johnny Weaver, who he retired with a top rope elbow drop. Valentine's elbow drop was promoted as a deadly move, with tapes of him breaking wooden boards with his elbow shown to the audiences before his debut. Valentine then formed a tag team with Ric Flair, with whom he twice won the NWA World Tag Team title and held the NWA Mid-Atlantic Tag Team Championship between June 30 and August 22, 1977. They first defeated Gene and Ole Anderson on December 26, 1976, who 9 years later would become in storyline Flair's cousins in Greensboro, injuring Gene so badly that he had to be stretchered out. They held the titles until May 8, 1977, when the Andersons defeated them in a steel cage match in the old Charlotte Coliseum. Flair and Valentine regained the tag titles from the Andersons on October 30, this time leaving Ole unable to leave under his own power. The team split after they were stripped of the titles in April 1978 by NWA President Eddie Graham as a result of their unprofessional conduct. Flair then set his sights on the NWA World Heavyweight Championship, while Valentine held the NWA World Tag Team Championships once more with Baron Von Raschke in 1978. At the same time, Valentine feuded with Chief Wahoo McDaniel over the NWA Mid-Atlantic Heavyweight Championship Wahoo had cost Valentine and Flair their first tag team championships. Wahoo, the then nemesis of Flair, had been the special referee in the steel cage match, so Valentine was eager for revenge. On June 11, 1977 in Raleigh, he defeated Wahoo, breaking his leg in the process. Though Wahoo's legs were too thick for Valentine to apply his signature figure four leglock, he managed to break Wahoo's ankle using a leg-ankle suplex. The heel Valentine then began wearing a t-shirt with the slogan "I broke Wahoo's leg" on the front and "No more Wahoo" on the back. Wahoo returned on August 9, 1977 and took back the title. Valentine would hold the title once more, defeating Wahoo again on September 10 and losing to Ken Patera on April 9, 1978. Worldwide Wrestling Federation, World Wrestling Federation 1978-1979, 1981-1982. Valentine began working on a casual basis for the Worldwide Wrestling Federation, then owned by Vincent J. McMahon. In November 1978, managed by the Grand Wizard, he was given the gimmick of a methodical wrestler who broke the legs of all his opponents, including Chief J. Strongbow. In February 1979, he wrestled then WWF Heavyweight Champion Bob Backlund to a one-hour time limit draw at Madison Square Garden. Valentine returned to the WWWF, now known as the World Wrestling Federation, for a year in 1981 and continued to pursue the title. On October 19, he was pinned by Backlund, but then handed the title belt by the dazed referee. The title was held up, and Backlund defeated Valentine cleanly in the November 23 rematch. In January 1982, Valentine met Backlund yet again, this time in a steel cage, for the WWF Heavyweight Championship at the Philadelphia Spectrum, which Backlund won. He also feuded with Pedro Morales over the WWF Intercontinental Heavyweight Championship, who he injured by suplexing him on the concrete floor of the arena. Valentine was not successful in winning this title either, and in mid-1982 left the promotion, returned to the NWA 1979-1984. Valentine returned to the NWA in late 1979 and asked Flair to reform their tag team. Flair, by then a face, declined. Valentine held the NWA World Tag Team Championship once more with Ray Stevens in 1984. Days after their victory, the promoter, David Crockett, told Valentine and Stevens that he possessed film which proved that the illegal man had been pinned in the tag match, nullifying the win. When Crockett threatened to send the film to Bob Gagel, then the NWA president, who would overturn their victory, Stevens and Valentine attacked him and cut the film up with a pocket knife, destroying the evidence. Valentine later claimed to have seen the light and reformed his team with Flair, who believed that Valentine was now a face in a tag match against Jimmy Snuka and the Iron Sheik. Valentine abandoned Flair, leaving him outnumbered. Flair was beaten, and then Valentine snapped Gene Anderson's hickory cane over his head, legitimately breaking his nose and splitting his lips. The former partners began feuding over Flair's NWA United States Heavyweight Championship, with Valentine finally defeating Flair for the title on July 26. In Flair's adopted hometown of Charlotte, he held the title until November 24, when he was beaten by Flair. Flair became one of Valentine's main opponents in the Mid-Atlantic Territory. Valentine would hold the United States Championship twice more, renewing his feud with Wahoo in 1982 and defeating him for the title on November 4 with the assistance of his manager, Sir Oliver Humperdinck. Roddy Piper began pursuing the title, and, after Piper gave Valentine a cake with a dog collar inside, the two had a series of brutal dog collar matches, most notably at Starrcade 1983, where Piper pinned Valentine in a non-title match after repeatedly whipping him with the steel chain. The feud was intensified by Valentine's propensity to focus on Piper's ear, which had been injured earlier in his career and would bleed easily. Piper would eventually defeat Valentine on April 16, 1983, but Valentine regained the title on April 30 in Greensboro, North Carolina, after the match, where he regained the U.S. title from Piper. Valentine hit Piper in the ear with U.S. title. He dropped the title to Dick Slater on December 14, just before leaving them for the World Wrestling Federation return to the WWF 1984-1992. Valentine went back to the WWF in 1984, predicting that Vince McMahon's plan for national expansion would succeed. His first manager was Captain Lou Albano, and he was later managed by Jimmy Hart on September 24, 1984 in London, Ontario. Ontario Valentine defeated Tito Santana for the WWF Intercontinental Heavyweight Championship, focusing on Santana's injured knee throughout the match. Santana initially thought he had the match won, but had in fact only achieved a two count as Santana was celebrating. Valentine rolled him up for the pin and the title following the win. Valentine put Santana in the figure four leglock, re-injuring him while Santana was sidelined having leg surgery. Valentine feuded with the Junkyard Dog, who he faced in an Intercontinental Heavyweight Championship title match at the very first WrestleMania held in Madison Square Garden. Valentine pinned the JYD after using the ropes, but Santana came to ringside and informed the referee, who restarted the match. Valentine then walked out, losing the match by count out but saving his title. Santana eventually healed and fought Valentine in many matches after Santana returned to the ring by defeating the Executioner in the first ever match at WrestleMania. He went on to win the title back on July 6, 1985 in a steel cage match in Baltimore, ending Valentine's 285-day reign, the fifth longest in Intercontinental title history. Valentine, incensed over losing the championship belt, destroyed it in the steel cage, forcing the WWF to get a new Intercontinental Heavyweight Championship belt. In reality, this was pre-planned, as the WWF already had a newer, more modern Intercontinental Heavyweight Championship belt made, and destroying the old title belt was seen as the perfect way to introduce the new one. Valentine would then form a tag team with Brutus Beefcake known as the Dream Team, managed by Johnny V. On August 24, 1985, the Dream Team defeated the U.S. Express Barry Windham and Mike Rotunda for the WWF Tag Team Championship. They held the titles until April 7, 1986, when they were defeated at WrestleMania 2 by the British Bulldogs. At WrestleMania 3, the Dream Team defeated Jacques Rougeau and Raymond Rougeau as a result of interference by Johnny V and Dino Bravo upset because of a missed move by Beefcake during the match. Valentine left with Bravo and abandoned Beefcake, resulting in Brutus turning face later on in the night, replacing Beefcake with Dino Bravo. Valentine formed the new Dream Team. Valentine was unhappy about teaming with Bravo, who he felt he had little chemistry with, after the WWF asked him to kidnap Matilda, the bulldog mascot of the British Bulldogs. Valentine resigned. He was brought back soon after, with Jimmy Hart as his new manager, but was used in a much diminished role between 1987 and 1990. In 1988, Valentine feuded with newly turned face Don "The Rock" Morocco, after Valentine viciously attacked Morocco's manager, former WWF heavyweight champion superstar Billy Graham. Graham, walking with a cane, tried to intervene when Valentine held the figure four leglock on jobber Ricky Itachi. After already winning the match, Valentine then put the figure four leglock on Graham, who had a plastic hip. Valentine was entered in the WWF World Heavyweight Championship tournament at WrestleMania IV, where he defeated Ricky Steamboat before losing to Randy Savage, the eventual winner of the tournament. In April 1989, he began feuding with Rugged Ronnie Garvin. 2 weeks after WrestleMania V, he defeated Garvin in a retirement match on Superstars of Wrestling by reversing a small package and holding on to the ropes. Garvin became a referee until Valentine and Hart managed to have him fired. Garvin then became a ring announcer, and began aggravating Valentine at SummerSlam 1989 for his match with Hercules. He announced Valentine as being Hercules' so-called opponent, and at 249 submit. Valentine left with his rhythm and blues tag team partner, the Honky Tonk Man. Shortly after, Valentine formed a tag team with the Honky Tonk Man, who was also managed by Jimmy Hart for around 8 months. Valentine resisted dyeing his hair black, an idea of Jesse the Body Ventura, but eventually relented, and the team became known as Rhythm and Blues and were managed by Hart. Rhythm and Blues feuded with the Bushwhackers and the Hart Foundation, but were overshadowed by the Legion of Doom, who were by then dominating the tag division. Famously, during the time of Rhythm and Blues, WWF announcer Gorilla Monsoon would proclaim every time Valentine got on the microphone and sang that, "If you hung the hammer for being a good singer, you would hang an innocent person." Valentine turned on Honky Tonk Man and became a face in December 1990. On January 19, 1991, Valentine participated in the fourth annual Royal Rumble match, where he lasted 44 minutes. He was to feud with his former partner, the Honky Tonk Man, but Honky left the WWF before the feud could begin. Valentine lost to Earthquake at WrestleMania 7, and was defeated again at SummerSlam 1991 by Irwin R. Shyster. He participated in the 1992 Royal Rumble, where he attacked his old rival Ric Flair before being eliminated by Repo Man. Returned to WCW 1992. Conscious of his diminishing status, Valentine left the WWF and signed with World Championship Wrestling in 1992, he formed a tag team with Terry Taylor for 6 months, and the duo went on to win the WCW United States Tag Team Championship after Taylor was fired. Valentine was left without an angle, and eventually resigned in late 1992 when he was asked to lose to Sting's second return to the WWF 1993. 1994, he reappeared in the WWF at the 1993 Survivor Series under a mask as the Blue Knight in an elimination match pitting Shawn Michaels, who was substituting for Jerry Lawler and his three Knights, who also included Barry Horowitz as the Red Knight and Jeff Gaylord as the Black Knight, against the Hart family. He would return again, as Greg Valentine, at the 1994 Royal Rumble, lasting over 20 minutes before being eliminated by Rick Martel that summer. Valentine would wrestle three times in a July house show tour, facing Bob Backlund on each occasion. Second return to the WCW 1996-1998. On July 1, 1996, Valentine returned to WCW and faced Randy Savage on Monday Nitro in Landover. MD Valentine was used primarily on television, facing the Giant, Harlem Heat, and Lex Luger. The following year he was used sparingly as well, again on television, but had a 6-2 record, defeating Mike Enos, Bobby Eaton, and Billy Kidman. Valentine wrestled four times for the promotion in 1998 and was 3-1. He finished his WCW run with a victory over Pat Tanaka on February 17, 1998, Independent Circuit 1994. Present Valentine went on to tour the Independent Circuit, wrestling in Japan, with the Hamilton-based International Championship Wrestling promotion and with the American Wrestling Federation starting in the summer of 1996. Valentine made several appearances with WCW over the course of the next 2 years. He was used on a pay-per-appearance basis, but was rarely utilized and was allowed to continue wrestling on the Independent Circuit. On October 10, 1999, he appeared on the infamous Heroes of Wrestling pay-per-view, pinning George the Animal Steel with the assistance of Sherry Martel. He wrestled on the 2000 tour of the United Kingdom, in which Yokozuna died. He was also involved with the short-lived X Wrestling Federation as an investor and as an in-ring performer in the 2000s. He began reducing his independent dates in order to pursue a career in real estate. Valentine right in the ring with Reed Flair in 2009. On January 29, 2005, at Wrestler Union, Valentine won a 17-man battle royal to become the IWA heavyweight champion. He lost the title to Tito Santana at Wrestler Union No. 2 on August 27 of that year. Valentine also wrestled for several independent promotions, including AWA Superstars of Wrestling, which toured New England in AWA Superstars of Wrestling. Valentine regularly wrestled Tony Atlas. In May 2007, Valentine defeated Quinson Valentino to win the Canadian Grand Prix Wrestling Championship in Morrisburg, Ontario. On August 24, 2007, Valentine returned to Ontario to defend the CGPW Championship against Coco Beware in Cornwall, after Coco defeated Valentine in a non-title match. On the previous night, in Ottawa, Valentine was successful in defeating Coco in Cornwall, though the title was vacated due to inactivity. In late 2007, Greg Valentine made an appearance in JCW or Juggalo Championship Wrestling, reforming the Dream Team with Brutus Beefcake in an 8-team elimination match for the then-vacant JCW Tag Team titles, where they were the first team to be eliminated after a slightly botched sunset flip from Necro Butcher. On January 29, 2011, Valentine was inducted into the Legends Pro Wrestling Hall of Fame by Jack Blaze in Wheeling, West Virginia at their annual LPW Over the Edge event. Brief returns to WWE 2004, 2005, 2008. On March 13, 2004, Valentine was inducted into the WWE Hall of Fame by his former manager Jimmy Hart. The following night, at WrestleMania XX at Madison Square Garden, Valentine received loud applause when the class of 2004 was introduced shortly after being inducted into the WWE Hall of Fame. Valentine dedicated the plaque he received to his late father by saying, "This one's for you, Pop, Johnny Valentine." On October 3, 2005, Valentine made an appearance at WWE Homecoming, and on October 23 he was defeated by Rob Conway, then using a gimmick similar to That of Randy Orton's gimmick of The Legend Killer on an episode of WWE Heat after Eugene interfered on his behalf, causing the referee to award a victory via disqualification to Conway. He was present at the retirement ceremony of his longtime friend, Ric Flair, on the March 31, 2008 episode of WWE Raw. Personal life: Greg married Julie on February 14, 1995. He has two daughters, Vanessa and Romaine, from his first wife, who once appeared on WWF TV in 1984 to give Valentine a back rub, which he claimed was the secret of his success. Vanessa began training with the Hart brothers in the late 1990s. He is a born-again Christian and occasionally speaks at high schools and colleges with Ted DiBiase. He is also a part of Christian wrestling organization World Impact Wrestling. He is the brother-in-law of wrestler Brian Knobbs. Valentine has appeared on an episode of Hogan Knows Best as one of Hulk's party guests. He also co-starred in Fuse's Insane Clown Posse Theater along with Insane Clown Posse members Violent J and Shaggy 2 Dope. The cast was rounded out with Michelle Sugar Slam Rap, Kevin Gill, and Vampiro. Valentine played an usher who ejected guests from the theater when their time is up on the show. Opinions towards female athletes. In August 2015, Valentine appeared on the Filsinger Games podcast and made several statements that degrade female MMA fighters, boxers and wrestlers. I love women, but they gotta realize their place. They're not supposed to be wrestlers. They're not supposed to be MMA fighters or boxers. It's bullshit. As far as girl wrestling, I would send them all out to the strip bar and fire them. I'd fire every girl wrestler I ever saw. They don't draw any money. They have horrible matches. Oh, they're terrible. That's the way I feel. They take away jobs from men that need to support their families. They should be home washing dishes and cooking and pregnant and barefoot. It was all in jest, of course, and reflecting on his heel persona. The live remarks can be found in the audio file of that podcast, starting at minute 40 in wrestling finishing moves figure 4 leglock, sometimes with a shin guard on his calf to amplify the effects of the move. Signature moves: back elbow smash, belly to back suplex, bionic elbow, elbow drop, knife edge chop, piledriver, pointed elbow drop to the opponent's midsection, vertical suplex with the honky tonk man, double belly to back suplex. Managers: Skandor Akbar, Captain Lou Albano, Grand Wizard Jimmy Hart, Sir Oliver Humperdinck, Luxurious Lynn Medusa, Rico Suave, Johnny Valiant, Darren Wise, Mr. Terrific, Tim Lawler, Larry Sweeney. Nicknames: The Hammer, Boxcar Willie. Themes: Hammer, WWF, Satan's Sister, NWA. Championships and accomplishments: Alabama Wrestling Federation AWF Heavyweight Championship, AWF Tag Team Championship, with Brutus Beefcake, American Wrestling Association AWA Midwest Tag Team Championship 2 times, with Jerry Miller, American Wrestling Federation AWF Tag Team Championship 1 time, with Tommy Rich, Bad Boys of Wrestling BBOW Heavyweight Championship 1 time, Canadian Grand Prix Wrestling CGPW Heavyweight Championship 1 time. International World Class Championship Wrestling IWCCW Heavyweight Championship 1 time, International Wrestling Association IWA Heavyweight Championship 1 time, Legends Pro Wrestling LPW Hall of Fame Class of 2011, Maple Leaf Wrestling NWA Canadian Heavyweight Championship Toronto Version 1 time, Mid-Atlantic Championship Wrestling World Championship Wrestling NWA Mid-Atlantic Heavyweight Championship 2 times, NWA Mid-Atlantic Tag Team Championship 1 time, with Ric Flair, NWA Mid-Atlantic Television Championship 2 times, NWA Television Championship 2 times, NWA United States Heavyweight Championship 3 times, NWA World Tag Team Championship Mid-Atlantic Version 4 times, with Baron Von Raschke 1, Ray Stevens 1, and Ric Flair 2, WCW United States Tag Team Championship 1 time, with Terry Taylor, National Wrestling Alliance. NWA North American Heavyweight Championship 1 time, NWA Hollywood Wrestling NWA America's Heavyweight Championship 2 times, NWA Beat the Champ Television Championship 2 times, New England Wrestling Alliance NAWA Hall of Fame Class of 2013, North State Wrestling Alliance NSWA Tag Team Championship 1 time, with the Honky Tonk Man NWA Texas NWA North American Heavyweight Championship 1 time, NWA Tri-State NWA United States Tag Team Championship Tri-State Version 2 times, with Bill Watts 1 and Gorgeous George Jr. 1, NWA Western States Sports NWA Western States Tag Team Championship 1 time, with Don Fargo, National Wrestling Federation NWF World Tag Team Championship 4 times, with Don Fargo Prime Wrestling. Prime Tag Team Championship one time, with Jim Neidhart Professional Wrestling Hall of Fame Class of 2016 Portland Wrestling Portland Pacific Northwest Heavyweight Championship two times Professional Wrestling Federation PWF Heavyweight Championship one time Pro Wrestling Illustrated PWI Most Hated Wrestler of the Year 1975, 1979, 1983 PWI ranked him number 49 of the top 500 singles wrestlers in the PWI 500 in 1992 PWI ranked him number 119 of the top 500 singles wrestlers of the PWI years in 2003 Pro Wrestling Ohio PWO Tag Team Championship one time, with Jim Neidhart Pro Wrestling Revolution PWR Heavyweight Championship one time Windy City Pro Wrestling WCPW League Heavyweight Championship one time. World Wrestling Council WWC Caribbean Heavyweight Championship one time WWC Universal Heavyweight Championship one time World Wrestling Federation Entertainment WWF Intercontinental Heavyweight Championship one time WWF Tag Team Championship one time, with Brutus Beefcake WWE Hall of Fame Class of 2004 References Carat Greg Valentine's Profile, at WrestlingData.com Carat ABCDEFGHIJKLMN Greg Valentine Profile Online World of Wrestling Retrieved 23 June 2011. Carat Cawthon, Graham 2013 The History of Professional Wrestling, The Results WWF 1963-1989 CreateSpace Independent Publishing Platform p. http://greg-valentine-sexist-comments-on-women's-wrestling/carat http://hussidianellipsing.com/p/3/e/d/3@c9c896f9c8/7/theviceufmp3c_id=9650865 Carat ICW, IWCCW Heavyweight Title History at Wrestling Titles.com Carat NWA Canadian Heavyweight Title Toronto History at Wrestling Titles.com Carat NWA Mid-Atlantic Heavyweight Title History at Wrestling Titles.com Carat NWA Mid-Atlantic Tag Team Title History at Wrestling Titles.com Carat ABNWA Mid-Atlantic Television Title History at Wrestling Titles.com Carat NWA, WCW United States Heavyweight Title History at Wrestling Titles.com Carat NWA World Tag Team Title Mid-Atlantic, WCW History at Wrestling Titles.com Carat NWA, WCW United States Tag Team Title History at Wrestling Titles.com Carat ABNWA North American Heavyweight Title History at Wrestling Titles.com Carat NWA America's Heavyweight Title History at Wrestling Titles.com Carat NWA Beat the Champ Television Title Los Angeles History at Wrestling Titles.com Carat NWA United States Tag Team Title Tri-State Version History at Wrestling Titles.com Carat NWA Western States Tag Team Title History at Wrestling Titles.com Carat NWF World Tag Team Title History at Wrestling Titles.com Carat Title History Prime Tag Team Championship Prime Wrestling Retrieved August 31, 2013 Carat WWC Universal Heavyweight Title History at Wrestling Titles.com Carat WWF, WWE Intercontinental Heavyweight Title History at Wrestling Titles.com Carat WWWF, WWF, WWE World Tag Team Title History at Wrestling Titles.com Carat WWF, WWE Hall of Fame Inductees at Wrestling Titles.com External links Professional Wrestling Portal Wikimedia Commons has media related to Greg Valentine Official website WWE Hall of Fame Profile Greg Valentine at the Internet Movie Database VENWA North American Heavyweight Champions Greg Valentine Kevin Von Erich Johnny Hawk Tommy Cairo Reckless Youth Lance Diamond Ace Darling Jeff Jarrett Barry Windham The Colorado Kid Chris Michaels Big Bully Douglas Terry Taylor Air Paris Chris Harris Steve Carino Jorge Estrada Hotstuff Hernandez Drew Onyx Damian Wayne Mike DiBiase Apollo The Sheik Cahagas Jax Dane VE WWE United States Champions MACW, JCP 1975-1991 Harley Race Johnny Valentine Terry Funk Paul Jones Blackjack Mulligan Bobo Brazil Ric Flair Ricky Steamboat Mr. Wrestling Jimmy Snuka Roddy Piper Wahoo McDaniel Sergeant Slaughter Greg Valentine Dick Slater Magnum Ta Tully Blanchard Nikita Koloff Lex Luger Dusty Rhodes Barry Windham Michael Hayes Stan Hansen WCW 1991-2001 Sting, Rick Rude, Dustin Rhodes, Steve Austin, Jim Duggan, Big Van Vader, Kensuke Sasaki, One Man Gang, Conan, Eddie Guerrero, Dean Malenko, Jeff Jarrett, Steve McMichael, Kurt Hennig, Diamond Dallas Page, Raven Goldberg, Bret Hart, Scott Hall, Scott Steiner, David Flair, Chris Benoit, Sid Vicious, Lance Storm, Jen Rection, Shane Douglas, Rick Steiner, Booker T, WWF, E 2001, 2003 present, Booker T, Canyon, Tajiri, Rhino, Kurt Angle, Edge, Eddie Guerrero, Big Show, John Cena, Carlito, Caribbean, Cool, Orlando, Jordan, Chris Benoit, John Bradshaw, Layfield, Bobby Lashley, Finley, Mr. Kennedy, Montel, Vontavious, Porter, Matt Hardy, Shelton, Benjamin, Kofi Kingston, The Miz, Bret Hart, R-Truth, Daniel Bryan, Sheamus, Dolph Ziggler, Zack Ryder, Jack Swagger, Santino Marella, Antonio Cesaro, Dean Ambrose, Rusev, Seth Rollins, Alberto Del Rio, Kalisto, Roman Reigns, current WCW World Television Champions, Ivan Koloff, Paul Jones, Ric Flair, Angelo Mosca, Mr. Wrestling, Greg Valentine, Rufus R. Jones, Ricky Steamboat, Baron Von Raschke, Johnny Weaver, The Masked Superstar, Roddy Piper, Sweet Ebony Diamond, Ron Bass, Charlie Brown, Jimmy Valiant, Yosh LaDuke, Leroy Brown, Mike Rotundo, Dick Slater, Great Kabuki, Mark Youngblood, Tully Blanchard, Dusty Rhodes, Arn Anderson, Nikita Koloff, Rick Steiner, Sting, The Great Muta, The Z-Man, Bobby Eaton, Steve Austin, Barry Windham, Scott Steiner, Paul Orndorff, Lord Steven Regal, Larry Zbysko, Johnny B. Badd, The Renegade, Diamond Dallas Page, Lex Luger, Prince Iaukea, Ultimo Dragon, Alex Wright, Disco Inferno, Perry Saturn, Booker T, Rick Martel, Chris Benoit, Fit Finlay, Stevie Ray, Chris Jericho, Conan, Scott Hall, Jim Duggan, VE World Tag Team Champions, 1970s Luke Graham and Tarzan, Tyler, Carl Gotch and Rene Goulet, Mikel Shikluna and King Curtis, Iaukea, Chief J. Strongbow and Sonny King, Mr. Fuji and Professor Tanaka, Haystacks, Calhoun and Tony Garea, Dean Ho and Tony Garea, The Valiant Brothers, Jimmy and Johnny Valiant, Dominic DiNucci and Victor Rivera, Pat Barrett, The Blackjacks, Blackjack Mulligan and Blackjack Lanza, Louis Cerdan and Tony Parisi, The Executioners, Executioner No. 1 and Executioner No. 2, Chief J. Strongbow and Billy White, Wolf, Dino Bravo and Dominic DiNucci, The Yukon Lumberjacks, Lumberjack Eric and Lumberjack Pierre, Tony Garea and Larry Zbysko, Jerry and Johnny Valiant, Ivan Putski and Tito Santana, 1980s The Wild Samoans, AFA and Sika, Bob Backlund and Pedro Morales, Tony Garea and Rick Martel, The Moondogs, Moondog Rex and Moondog King, Moondog Spot, Mr. Fuji and Mr. Saito, Chief J and Jules Strongbow, Tony Atlas and Rocky Johnson, The North-South Connection, Adrian Adonis and Dick Murdoch, The U.S. Express, Mike Rotundo and Barry Windham, The Iron Sheik and Nikolai Volkoff, The Dream Team, Brutus Beefcake and Greg Valentine, The British Bulldogs, Dynamite Kid and Davey Boy Smith, The Hart Foundation, Bret Hart and Jim Neidhart, Strike Force, Rick Martel and Tito Santana, Demolition Axe, Smash and Crush, The Brain Busters, Arn Anderson and Tully Blanchard.